हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू आवर चैनल। दिस इज़ महक उपाध्याय, करेंटली सर्विंग एज लीगल इंटरनेट लेक्सिसन कंपनी। टुडेज टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन इज व्हाट इज नोटिस अंडर ट्रांसफर ऑफ प्रॉपर्टी एक्ट 1882। व्हेनेवर वी हर्ड दिस टर्म नोटिस, इज जस्ट वी इमेजिन अ रिटन नोटिस और समथिंग लाइक इन वॉट वी हैव स्टडी इन अ स्कूल। बट नोटिस अंडर ट्रांसफर ऑफ प्रॉपर्टी एक्ट इज लिटल इज कम्प्लीटली अ डिफरेंट कॉन्सेप्ट। इट्स नॉट अ रिटन डॉक्यूमेंट under section 3 of TPA. It's not a written document, but it's something a person possess mentally. So basically, under TPA section 3, notice is something is the knowledge of a person have regarding the possession of the property, regarding the documents of the property, something that a prudent person should possess. It is of two type. First is actual notice, second is constructive notice, and third is notice by agent. What is actual notice? Actual notice is the direct notice, that direct knowledge that a person could have. Means if I buy something, if I have a deal with the owner of a property that I am going to buy the house, and he told me that the house is at this location, has this wind services and rain in the location is at this centimeter, the condition of the house is this, there was some water leakage during rain, etc. These all are the actual notice that directly come from the owner, not from the third party, not by any kind of investigation of inquiry that has been made from my part. So that is what we called an actual notice. Second is constructive notice. Constructive notice is something that law presumes that an ordinary person of prudent person would have done before buying this property. For example, it may include who is in the actual possession of the property. Is it is the owner himself, or there was someone like tenant or the lessee or the mortgagee living in the property? If so, then what right they are living there? Was there any debt on the property? Was the property is some government property or the private property of the person? Was there any kind of sale deed between the tenant and the owner? These are some regular questions, or these are some common questions that court presume that the person before buying that property would definitely going to ask or to inquire himself. And if a person, due to some laziness or some negligence, abstain himself from making such inquiries that an ordinary prudent person would have done if he was in the position of that buyer, then after abstaining himself from making such inquiries, after this completion of the sale deed or the transfer of property, he found that the tenant was actually the first owner of the property. Means the owner already sold the property to him, and that there was the second transaction that was held between him and the owner, who was no more the owner of the property. So the court would say that what were you doing before buying the property? The tenant was in actual possession of the property. You had not made a try to ask to get inquired what was the actual right of that person living in there. You never asked him why you are living here, how long you are living here, and how long you will be living here. You abstain himself, you made this gross negligence that an ordinary person would not have done. So we are not responsible for anything, that you cannot claim that a fraud has been given because you himself was negligent on these things. So the court would not entertain his complaint on the ground that there must be a constructive notice on the part of him. But constructive notice could be the court can only say constructive notice, or in general he say, if the tenant is actually in possession of the house, means the owner was not he was maybe the owner live in some foreign country for about 10 years, the tenant lived there, he was in possession for 10 years, it's a quite long time. So before buying, is the duty that the law imposes on that buyer to inquire from that person that you are that how long you will be living here, for how long you are living and then what is your actual right. Maybe during the 10 years is a long time. Maybe that the owner could have shared his interest of the property in the name of him. That could be anything. That is a different situation. The court will presume that the person would have done. But what if the owner lives here and the person tenant who claimed that the property belongs to him after the deed was completed with the buyer and the owner, if that owner possess only 1/3 or even 1/7 or some small portion of the land and majority of the portion is in the hand of the ownership, then still the law will impose the same duty on the owner? The answer is no. If the owner is in the possession of the whole property, in actual possession of the house, or in the majority portion is in the hands of the of the tenant, then it's on the due it's on the buyer to get that to get the inquiry done by on his part, so that there could be no case of fraud against him in the future. But the same incident where the tenant was in just 1/2 possession was in Mustafa versus Hazi. The court clearly said when tenant occupies such a little portion, it cannot be presumed that he is the actual owner, or he could be the actual owner of the property, or there was some sale deed could have done between them if he is retaining only a small portion. So in that case, court would not presume. But if he whole enjoys the whole of the property, then it is the duty of the buyer to get the to ask him that by what right you are enjoying the property. And third and the last is notice by an agent. Well established the principle of a contract, then an agent who acts on behalf of the principal is then the principal is responsible for every act of the agent. Similarly, if an agent lawfully is exercising on behalf of a principal, then every notice or every knowledge possessed by the agent would be presumed as the same as the knowledge possessed by the principal. So if a person told something to the agent and agent told it principal, then the principal could not say that I was not aware of it, he did not directly call me. Because the principal was acting on behalf, acting through the agent, so any knowledge given to the agent would be as if it was given directly to the principal, provided the agent did not willfully abstain himself from providing any such knowledge to the principal, or provided he had not done any act fraudulently. For any fraudulent act of the agent, principal is not responsible. So this is for today. These all are the kinds of notice that is given in the section 3, and what and that is the duty the law presumed from the person buying a property. If you like this video, so do like, share and subscribe the channel. Thank you.